So a couple of days ago, I made a video talking about some of the new weapons that we're most likely going to see enter Infinite Warfare any day now. Maybe even today, it might be tomorrow. But these weapons now have actual names, and they also have variants that were found in the PC files. You can find a link down below in the description to the Reddit posting by Void Glitch. Make sure to check it out. You can also find a link to another posting showing the images of these weapons if you would like to see those. So let's talk about what's new. There are three brand new weapons. We have the UDM, the RVN, and of course, the axe, which has been rumored. The UDM is a semi-automatic pistol. The RVN is a fully automatic slash akimbo assault rifle. And the axe is, of course, a melee weapon. Each one of these weapons also have four variants each. Some of these variants are way better than the base model, which makes me wonder if they're going to do weapons a little bit differently than what we've seen in the past couple of years. Now, this may just be wishful thinking, but I want to throw an idea out there and see how it sticks. With previous years being Advanced Warfare and, of course, Black Ops 3, they shared a similar system of having to find those weapons in supply drops, and those are the only way that you'd be able to get those weapons. Advanced Warfare is the closest thing that we can compare to Infinite Warfare simply due to the fact that both games have variants. In order to unlock the base model of a specific new weapon, in Advanced Warfare at least, you needed to find a variant to unlock the base model. I'm thinking things are going to be a little bit different this year, because the variants themselves of, let's say, the Axe or the UDM or whatever, they're a lot better than what the base model would be. So what I'm thinking is, we'll have the ability to unlock the base model with Salvage, and we won't have to worry about simply using all of our keys to find that one weapon. Or, even more wishful thinking, and this is a long stretch of the imagination because we're talking about Activision here. What if they just gave us the base models for free, and then they added the variants of each weapon, because there are four each, within the Quartermaster Collection? And they rotated those other ones out. They got rid of the corruption and everything, put it into the normal rotation where we can use salvage to buy those if we wanted to. But then they add the new variants of the new weapons within the Quartermaster Collection, still allowing us, by the way, to have the base model. Who the hell am I kidding? That's not gonna happen. But salvage is there, and salvage can happen. So if there's any type of consolation of all of this, what I just talked about, what if they just put the weapons themselves within the standard prototype lab? That way we'd be able to craft whatever we wanted to. Maybe they don't even have a base version of the weapon. Maybe they just only have those four variants. So even if there were epic, rare, legendary, and common variants of those weapons, we'd have the opportunity to get them. And if they were in the game purchasable with salvage, that means we would only have to spend a minimum of 200 salvage in order to get the weapon that we want. Or go that extra mile and spend 600 salvage to get all three of common variants, of course. Now, this sounds good on paper, and in my mind, it sounds great, but I don't really know how it's gonna work. This is a weird year. I mean, think about the crafting system within Modern Warfare Remastered. Some of those weapons can only be found after using parts and completing sets. We don't have sets like that within Infinite Warfare. And of course, the Quartermaster Collection has been the same for a very long time, and I don't know if they're ready or willing to put those weapons into the standard prototype lab. Another thing is, too, I don't expect them to actually put these weapons within the Mark II selection either. I mean, sure, maybe they will sometime down the line, or maybe they might introduce them right away. But I don't feel like that would be the way that they lock them all together. Of course, each one of these weapons have to have their own type of camouflage earning skills and stuff like that, right? I don't know. This is very confusing. I'm trying to think of how they're going to add weapons in this game and do them without busting everybody's balls, it's kind of a hard thing to think about. I guess maybe that's why I'm having such wishful thinking, hoping that they're just going to put the base model in the game and just have the variants locked in the supply drops. But let's talk about those variants, because some of them are pretty dang cool. Starting with the UDM, there are four different variants. So the first one being common, we have the UDM Fleet. This is going to give you readiness, allow you to reload faster when the mag is empty. Next up, we have the Bonanza. This is going to give you a jackpot upgrade, which kills will grant an extra 10% score. Stockpile will give you increased ammo as well on that one. The UDM Mod 3, this is the legendary variant. It will give you the Hitman perk. Killing all enemies will grant a large payload bonus. and then Creeper will increase your movement speed while crouched. And finally, we have the epic variant of that weapon, and it will actually turn the pistol into a sniper. The sniper mod is the ability that you get, and it modifies the weapon into a single fire sniper pistol. Readiness will allow you to reload faster when the mag is completely empty. So we're taking a semi-automatic weapon and turning it into a sniper of sorts. I guess the same thing could be said about the Oni Kaiken. Remember that weapon? It's a single shot, it does a lot of damage. I feel like the UDM will be similar in the sense to the Oni Kaiken. Next up we have the RVN, the Tickler. This is a common and it's going to give you the sharpshooter perk, increased damage range. Next up, we have the RVN Brain Case Bruiser. This is the rare variant. Head Rush. Headshot kills will grant a small payload bonus. And then Lights Out will increase the weapon melee speed. Next up, we have the legendary RVN. It's called the Duality, and it's got the dynamic perk. Kills in alternating modes grant bonus score, and it also has stability, reduced recoil. And then finally, we have the RVN Blowout. This is the epic variant, and it's got something called Overcharge. Melee kills in alternative modes create a cone explosion, increases damage to score streaks, and you can stack that with the RAM servo. Creates a cone explosion? That kind of makes me think, what the heck do they mean? Now finally we have the axe, and the epic variant is badass. We're going to start with the common though to get your mind thinking. So we got the axe wood chipper, this is the common variant. It's going to increase your movement speed while crouched. Next up, we have the rare Skull Splitter. This is going to grant you an additional 10% score and give you slightly increased movement speed. Next up, we have the legendary version called the Axe Scythe, and this is going to give you Gambler. Three-player kill streaks will give you a random perk, and then Lights Out increases the weapon melee speed. That's going to be nice for a melee weapon. And finally, we have the Axe Headsman. This is the epic variant. And to me, this actually sounds pretty damn cool because it's something we've never seen in Call of Duty, period. And that is, you're able to throw the axe and pick it up. So that means you can treat it kind of like a throwing knife or something of the sort like that. The other ability is you'll get increased movement speed as well. So now that you guys have heard the variants, let me know down below in the comments section. Do you feel like the variants are much better than what you expected? Because that's why I'm starting to feel like they may just give us the base model. Or maybe they'll just give us the opportunity to craft the base model. I'm not really sure how they're going to do it. Once again, most of this video is just wishful thinking. I'd love to know what you guys think down below in the comment section. Once again, if you want to see this information, check it out linked down below in the description from Void Glitch over on Reddit. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to click the like button down below. Subscribe for more awesome videos coming each and every day. And until next time, my friends, I will see ya. Peace.